All right, hello again, YouTube. This is going to be a video about this fucking game that I keep hearing about, Hatred. You know, all right, I'm going to just come flat out and say I've already done it. I did a video about this, an audio video about it, and I had got to the point where I edited it down, and then I fucking deleted it because I thought, why am I wasting my time with this shit? Because it was just actually in response to Rich and, of Reviewtech USA's video about it, and people are all up in arms because Valve decided not to support the game. So now Boogie 2988 has come out with a video basically echoing the same shit. And you know, I get really fucking irritated hearing about this game. I mean, first of all, people are bitching, oh, it's censorship. Sorry, the government has not come out and fucking banned the game, first of all. You know, they've done that in Australia, first of all, with games like GTA 5, I believe, was banned. I mean, you know what? Like, holy fuck. It is so fucking exhausting to continue to hear about this fucking just horse shit of a game. You know, I reckon that this game is, I mean, you know what? If you want to play the game, you go do whatever the fuck you want. I mean, it's just sort of, I'm not here to fucking tell you what you should and shouldn't do. And if you want to go play the game Hatred, go play it. You know, we could have the take a shit on the toilet simulator too. And, you know, hey, you know, you want to make a diarrhea sandwich. How about that simulator? How about that game should be up on Steam? Nobody's fucking arguing about, you know, what kind of games should be allowed or whatever. This is, I think, a business decision on Steam's part. Or Valve's part, rather. I still do not like Valve. I don't like Steam. I don't like the whole idea of digital fucking games. But again, I'm going to stand on Valve's side on this one because, first of all, they have every right to put up whatever the fuck games they want in their fucking store. They have no obligation to post, you know, if I go and I develop a game, the diarrhea simulator, you know, let's go have a giant shit on the toilet. And it's like, oh, everybody wants to play the diarrhea game. Well, hey, they have no obligation to fucking, you know, post that to their website. You know, they choose what they support from a business perspective. You know, it's their fucking service. They can post whatever the fuck they want. They can support whatever they want. Now, so far as I understand, the green light, I don't know, system or whatever the fuck it is, you know, they have the community vote what games they want to be posted, I guess. Now, the developers of this game must have known out the fucking door before they even got, 2 seconds into developing this game, that it was going to be controversial, that it was going to push a lot of people's buttons. Okay. And it pushed my buttons. I mean, again, I think it's a piece of shit. I personally think it's just fucking retarded. There's absolutely no redeeming quality of the game. I mean, why am I going to play a game about murdering people? You want to play a game about murdering people, you go right fucking ahead. I really don't care, you know, but for me personally, no. I mean, there is, people draw the parallel between GTA 5 or the Grand Theft Auto series because it is violent. You can go around and you can kill people, right? The difference is there's a consequence. I've talked about this previously, that there seems to be a consequence in the game. I don't know that that's what's been programmed into Hatred, that there are consequences. It just seemed like from the premise of the trailer, of course, it's really hit a little bit hypocritical on my part to judge a game based on the trailer, because of course, if I did that, then every game would look like a piece of shit, more or less. But, you know, the idea just gets under my fucking skin, you know, there have been games in the past, like Carmageddon, for instance. You run around in vehicles and fucking run people over, which is, I don't know, now I'm laughing about that. But I think it was just that the way, you know, Carmageddon and these really ultra-violent games, the way it was presented, you know, there was an air of humor to it. But I guess, you know, I think we're being forced to look at games like this and media and books and whatever works and decide what, you know, is right for each, you know, I guess for ourselves. I shouldn't say for each other, because it's up to you to decide what the fuck you want to read and what you want to consume. It's just you sort of have to question, well, I mean, if you're gonna play a game like that, what the hell is the redeeming quality? I don't really see the appeal here. People jump on the, oh, it's a free speech thing. I don't see it as a free speech thing. I really don't. I mean, yeah, you can make a game about anything, but first of all, freedom of speech is not absolute. You guys have to get that in your head. I mean, there is no such thing as absolute freedom of speech. Hate speech, for instance, against certain races of people, certain religious and minority groups, has not been tolerated well in the last, you know, decade or so. There have been laws passed to prevent people from fucking talking that shit. You know, if you're in Germany, you talk about the Nazis or whatever, you're going to get thrown in jail. That's just the way it is. Supposedly, that's illegal over there. If you talk about, you know, if you call people, you know, racist remarks or whatever, I'm assuming that in some parts of the country, in the states, that it is illegal to do so. But then again, there are constitutional challenges and blah, blah, blah. How about let's not be dicks? How about that? You know, I mean, I look at this as, you know, I kind of have to question, well, what the hell is the appeal of the game? You can go play the game. As I said, this is not an issue of like, should the game be allowed? The game is developed, so far as I understand, it is available. And if you want it, so far as I understand, you can go to the website and fucking buy the stupid thing. You know, I don't see this as a censorship issue. I don't see it as a free speech issue, you know, because the game is available. It's not like the government has released this. I haven't heard one goddamn thing from the media or from, you know, the government or anything releasing any kind of official statement. Oh, we've heard about this game. It's fucking terrible. We're not going to let anyone play it. We're going to ban it. It's still available. So again, I think the company who made this is just laughing their fucking asses off because you got people running around like their fucking hair's on fire. Oh, it's freedom of speech, blah, 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 blah. And I think they knew this was going to happen. This is like the Mortal Kombat game, you know, when it came out back in the 90s, it fucking stirred a lot of pots and people, you know, rubbed people the wrong way, you know, when you rip somebody's fucking head off. The difference was that there was a combat element. It was a fight, you know, you didn't have to fucking do a fatality every time. And in this game, I think the premise is to run around killing people. I mean, if the, you know, you hear people in the trailer pleading for their lives, no, please, please, and then they get their fucking head blown off or whatever, and this dickhead is running around in the game, the sort of, the guy who has a chip on his shoulder the size of the fucking, you know, moon or whatever, running around like the fucking world owes him something, and I think that's what pissed me off. There's nothing likable about the character, there's nothing that I would find redeeming in the game. I mean, it's different if it was like, you know, in the context of like a zombie game, you know, there's some fucking danger element, you know, there's a threat, there's some kind of, you know, something that has to be mitigated or dealt with by the player. And I guess in the context of this game, I don't understand what the fuck the player's supposed to do. I mean, if this is like murder porn or whatever, you just run around slaughtering people. I think you have to be kind of fucking demented, you know, and a bit warped for this to be a fucking, of any form of enjoyment. But that's, you know, my opinion, and I don't think anyone has to agree with it. I'm just saying, like, I don't get it. It seems like a lot of people don't get it. I read the comments. I see almost a 50-50 split about people who are on the fence about, like, you know, they really don't give a shit. I see another bunch that are all like, oh, this is freedom of speech. Fuck this. You know, we can't give them an inch or whatever, you know, because then they'll be fucking banning everything. You know, it's just, again, I think there is no hard limit, right? But I mean, there is a sort of like, don't be a dick kind of a thing. And I mean, really, if you want to talk about the free speech issue, there are legal channels to challenge that kind of a thing with the government. If the government comes out against certain forms of speech or whatever, you have the right to go fight it. But of course, it's going to cost you a fuckload of money to bring it all the way up to the Supreme Court, and whether or not they're going to fucking hear your goddamn bullshit. You know, I mean, yeah, there in certain instances, there's a legitimate fucking argument for free speech. But in this case, I don't see it because it's not being banned. So I don't know where the fuck people are going with this. Oh my God, Steam didn't fucking support it. They're censoring it. It's like, God, would you fucking people get a grip? Holy shit, man. They have no obligation. It's like, if I have a service, I can fucking dictate what the hell I'm going to host on my service. You know, it's a business decision, guys. It's a fucking, they have a brand to uphold here. And if they're going to start putting out a rapes, I mean, that I know that's coming down the pipe. It's going to be coming down the pipe because of the of this game. You have a murder simulator, you're going to have a fucking rape simulator, a shit on your head simulator, eat the diarrhea sandwich simulator. I mean, where does it fucking end? It doesn't end, because that's what we got to do here with, you know, it seems like humans are out to just push buttons, push, see how fucking much you can push that button. And I find that that's the, you know, there's a difference between making a legitimate argument and being a dick, you know? And I think in this case, they're just taking the fucking piss, all right? Anyway, I'm out of time. Hope you guys enjoyed. I don't know, leave your comments what you think of this fucking stupid goddamn game. I don't want to hear anything about this thing, but it just keeps going and going and going. I thought I had to say something. Anyway, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.